MC Saar and the Real McCoy, another night, classic 90s. Gareth in Cardiff says, double denim because Bewitched are coming in. Scott, what do you like? I know. Happy birthday to Helen at Rock House Dental Practice in Wales in Somerset, another dental practice, listening to Radio 2. Happy birthday, Helen. Aaron, harvesting in Aberdeenshire, made the switch over with me. Hello. Welcome to the show. It's Radio 2, BBC Sounds app, smart speaker, 88 to 91 FM.
With the BBC News at 3 o'clock, this is Jason Kay. President Biden has used a speech in Belfast for the 25th anniversary of the Good Friday Agreement to call for a recommitment to power sharing. He told an audience at Ulster University that Northern Ireland had been transformed by peace and praised political leaders who signed the deal in 1998, warning that peace was not inevitable. Mr. Biden also held a 45-minute meeting with Rishi Sunak, who said afterwards that relations between the UK and the US were in great shape.
And we spoke in particular about the incredible economic opportunities that are there in store for Northern Ireland, about the investment potential that is there, the companies that want to invest in Northern Ireland. I think that's incredibly exciting. It will bring growth, jobs and prosperity to Northern Ireland. And I know he shares my ambition to see the institutions here back up and running. That's what people and businesses in Northern Ireland deserve.
Mr. Biden is now travelling to the Irish Republic. Strong winds mean he's going by car rather than helicopter, as was originally planned. The Scottish Government is to begin a legal challenge to Westminster's block on its controversial gender reforms, which would allow people to self-identify their gender earlier. The UK government says it'll robustly defend its position. Our Scotland editor James Cook reports.
The bill would remove medical, legal and administrative hurdles which must currently be cleared before changing the sex recorded on a birth certificate. It would also cut the age limit to do so from 18 to 16. It was passed by the Scottish Parliament in December, but then blocked by the UK government because of its potential impact on British equality legislation. Shirley Ann Somerville, Scotland's Justice Secretary, said she was seeking judicial review of that move because she was determined to uphold the democratic decision of the Scottish Parliament and to ensure what she called proper protection of devolution.
A 45-year-old man is denied murdering his elderly mother in their home in Chipping, Camden, in the Cotswolds. Matthew Curry appeared before a judge at Bristol Crown Court, accused of killing 84-year-old Beatrice Curry in January. The billionaire Elon Musk has said that running Twitter has been quite painful and a roller coaster. In a hastily arranged interview for the BBC, he insisted that misinformation had not increased on the platform since he took over, even though he's reduced content moderation. A communications expert, Drew Benvie, says Mr. Musk was open about what he'd learned since taking over Twitter.
He talked about the, he called them haphazard firings. The first thing he did was he tried to save the company money, but I think he's wrangling with this. Should I have saved money quite so quick, or should I have tried to get more people using it? And I think that was one of the main learnings coming from this interview, that he'd wished he'd focused more on growing the social network.
Barclays has announced plans to close a further 15 branches across the UK this summer. The announcement means 73 of Barclays' sites will shut in 2023. Other banks are also closing dozens of branches because fewer customers are using them. And that's the BBC News at 3 minutes past three.
Scott Mills. Rihanna and Little Mix coming up. I wasn't joking about the outfit change, by the way. Check out my double denim on Radio 2 Instagram right now. Bewitched at 3:30. Radio.